Hello and welcome to today's video that is brought to you by my Patreons. If you also appreciate my content and would like to support my channel, don't hesitate to visit my Patreon page. The link is in the description. And let me also welcome the new Patreons. Thank you very much for the support, guys. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to make this tool, which is used to keep the top and back in place when you are working on the arching and on the thickness. A lot of you have requested to make this video, so there we go. But as yesterday it was Christmas, and in Christmas time we give gifts to each other, I have something for you. I'm giving away two molds of Grandi-Lutai, the famous ones. Keep watching the video to see and find out how you can participate to the giveaway. First of all, let's have a look to the materials that you need to make it. You will need two pieces of plywood, one about 10 mm thick and the other one between 15 and 18 mm thick. Another piece of plywood about 6 mm thick, 4 to 5 cm wide and about 15 cm long. This piece is a bit bigger. You will need two carriage bolts of 6 mm thick and 60 mm long, a couple of wing bolts and two rings. And you will need the template that you can download using the link in the description. We will start by preparing the template. You can download it by using the link in the description and print it on A4 paper. Then you will have to cut at the edge of the lines of page B. Now you can attach part B to C and A and stick them together with a little bit of paper. The template is ready. Now I'm going to attach the two pieces of wood together because I want to cut them together. Using the template, I'm going to put four marks to put four screws. The head of the screw has to go completely into the wood because it will become the underside. Now I'm going to turn the two pieces upside down and glue the template in place. I'm going to use this kind of spray glue. Keep in mind to put the large part at the same side that you have put the large part at the underside with the screws. Now I have to wait. By the way, if you are working on your new instrument or you are restoring an old one and you need fittings, have a look to my merchandise store where you can find different sets of fittings for violin. The glue is dry, so I'm going to cut now the outer line, and I'm going to do that on the bandsaw, but if you don't have one, you can also use a jigsaw. I finished cutting. Now you can finish the outer side, making it a bit smoother with the files. You can also leave it like that. I'm going to make it smoother and I'm going to use my belt sander. Now it is nice and smooth. That means that I can go ahead and separate the two pieces again and then cut the part that has to go away in the inner side of the upper part. And again, there are two ways to do that. You can drill a hole and then use the jigsaw to cut it out, or you can enter at one side with a bandsaw and cut it. And this is what I am going to do. That means that this kind of circle that I will have will be moving as it will be open at one side, but that's not a big deal because I'm going to fix it here again, so it will get fixed. Thank you. This part is ready. I also cleaned the inner parts with a sander. Now setting up the bandsaw to cut on an angle, I have cut two pieces of wood that are going to become these parts that go in this gap and move up and down so you can clamp the top or back that you are working on. These are ready. Now I have to make the gap here. I see that I forgot to mark the position of these on my template. I'm going to do that so the template that you are going to download will also have here a couple of markings. And there are also here two marks for the screws for the upper parts. Now let me mark and cut the space for these parts. To go ahead, I want to remove the paper, but before I will mark these two spots. Now I'm going to cut at the angle of these two lines until here. I remove the part with the bandsaw and now I'm going to fit this perfectly. I will use my files and I see that I have to remove a bit on this side. This is ready now, it is a nice fit, and I also made this one. Now I can drill the hole, and for that I'm going to use my push drill. The holes are in, now I'm going to screw the two parts together again. And now using the piece of wood as guide, I'm going to put it in the place and drill the hole through. The screws are in place. On the bandsaw I have cut four small pieces that are going here and here. The upper two can be drilled and screwed in the center. The lower ones have to be drilled out of center because the two screws pass from the center. So that's it, the tool is ready. Now you can use your own top or back to make these parts a bit round. I have left them flat for the time being. I'm going to change them when I'm going to use this tool on an instrument. Both sides you can change, and you can also change the position of these parts on the tool according to the length of the model that you are making. So that's it for today's video, but not before I tell you how you can win one of the two molds. I have two different models. One is a Guarneri del Gesù 1733 Chrysler, and the other one is the Antonio Stradivari 1716 Messia. Go to the comments below and leave a comment writing which one you would like to have. And if you are a Patreon, go to my Patreon page and find the picture that I will put there and leave there a comment with the one that you would like to have. Patreons go first. Don't wait too long to leave a comment because I'm going to announce the winner on the 1st of January. Many thanks to the Patreons for supporting the channel. Enjoy the holidays. Now you have something to do. Next week it is New Year. I wish everyone a very happy New Year, and I hope that 2021 will become a bit better than 2020. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and like the video, and I will see you next time again. Bye bye!